dark basement in a haunted dwelling somewhere in the black swamps of Northwest Ohio. This is Swamp Gas, and I am your host, Arizona Tramp. Now, I have started to come ill, but it's no biggie. The deal with the radio show. All right, well, I still do not have a decent computer to use. So I am making this podcast because there's information out there that I'm about to tell you about that you really need to hear, listen to, and pay attention to. You might notice the difference in my voice. That's because I'm ill, but I figure it kind of helps the show out a little bit. Now, the first thing I'm going to lead off with, and don't laugh about this, pay attention to it, because it's legit. People a few weeks ago brought attention to the snow and how it wasn't melting properly, so on and so forth. Well, even Ground Zero came out on the air and said there's something up with this. I have some people who took some snow into both universities around where I live, and they just said it was the snow. They tried to get it analyzed, the water analyzed. Well, they were turned away. Other people went in, but they were smarter about it. They said, "Can you test my well water?" They tested the well water, and it came back like this. And before I go any further, this is one email that I have received from someone who was a truck driver. His name is going to remain anonymous. But in this email, Snow Witch, I'm going to read this part of it. Snow Witch turned into water was collected from the following states: Ohio, Illinois, Montana, Michigan, and another state that I will not mention simply because that is the person's state that they live in. They wish to remain anonymous. The samples were then sent to the following universities for analysis: UC Berkeley and North California universities, both of them. They were given to the universities under the guise of, "Will you test my water, my well water, with a water quality analysis test?" The following results were apparently found and revealed. Now, I don't have the actual paper sitting in front of me, so you take this for what it's worth. As a matter of fact, why don't you take it and have it tested as well water under the guise of well water? Make sure you document what you are doing with video. Make sure you document on the video that, yeah, okay, I'm going to call this well water, but this is the water from the snow. This is a big deal, and I will explain why in a minute. The snow / water showed high levels of aluminum, barium, beryllium, cesium, and cesium-131. Cesium-131 is the radioactive signature for Fukushima. Cesium is just radioactivity. It's not traceable. The levels of these chemicals are considered to be toxic to humans and to animals, and the consumption as well as skin contact should be avoided. So, this is a big deal. One person said to me when I said something to them, "Oh, well, I'm glad that the water's going to melt and then it won't be a problem." Well, that is exactly the opposite. The truth is the water's going to melt and it will become a big problem. The water will go into the water table, the contaminated water. The earth will act as a filter for the heavy metals. But the radiation, the earth, the ground is no filter for that. Now, the water goes into the water table, the water stays in the ground a couple feet down. We plant our crops, and the crops are then contaminated with radiation. The frozen lakes, like Lake Erie, which is next to me, within as the crow flies, probably 10 miles away. The river, which is probably 2 miles away from me. The Great Lakes are all ice covered, meaning this contaminated, irradiated snow and rainfall stays above the water of the lake. So instead of the fish and the life in the water getting mild doses from one step at a time and becoming, their bodies becoming familiar and used to it, it's going to hit them like a bombshell. Fish could potentially end up floating on the top of the lakes and of the rivers because the radiation is just too high. Now, the radiation, they may say, well, the radiation is safe. Okay, but the way radiation works, it's the same way mercury works. It's the same way fluoride works. Now, pay attention here. All right, let's just say you have a piece of paper. Okay, that piece of paper is radioactive, but by itself, that piece of paper doesn't do much. We'll keep stacking paper on top of each other, and pretty soon, it becomes lethal. It doesn't go away, it accumulates. So their sample that they claim is, oh, not a problem. Well, when you keep compounding that on top of each other, it becomes a big problem. And it's not done snowing yet. And the problems from Fukushima are building and building and building. This is an issue that needs to be paid attention to. And only we can stop it because the government seems to not give a damn. Snoops.com. I don't put anything to Snoops.com anymore because Snoops.com seems to blow off things as saying, oh, there's no proof of this. There's nothing to this. I am going to jump ahead to the next story here. And there's a story that says, all European newborn babies will be microchipped with an RFID tag or film microchip strip embedded in their skin come May of 2014. Now, I remember this story. Snoops.com says it's not so. I remember seeing this story written several different places that are credible. And even though Snoops.com thinks that there's nothing to it, I disagree. You don't have to listen to me. Like I just told you, go have the water tested yourself. Don't take my word for it. Go have the water tested for yourself. And when enough people do this and then go to the news, well, the news is not going to be able to ignore it because they're going to get 500 phone calls to the newsroom a day saying, why aren't you covering this? And pretty soon, it's not going to be kept secret and they're going to have to cover it. Now, with the microchip deal, I don't know what to tell you about that. But it's something to watch out for. My personal view is, why do they need to bother to microchip anybody when everybody and their brother owns a damn cell phone, at least one? I don't. You couldn't pay me to own a cell phone, but I'm one of those few people, probably because I'm over 50, that can deal with not having one. And now on to the next story. All right. This is being paraphrased, by the way. But an airline mechanic blows the whistle on chemtrail operations. And I'm paraphrasing. What happened was this airline mechanic describes how the pecking order works at an airport and how there's usually only certain people who do things like, for example, clean out the septic tanks of the airplanes. And he explains how one day when he had to do this by chance, he looked up inside and saw more tanks than what was supposed to be. He saw that they weren't hooked up exactly the same. He saw they were not part of the septic system. And he saw that they were hooked up to the little air control fixtures on the outside of the plane that were dummies. And that this is where the chemtrails would be sprayed from the bottom of the airplane outward. This story comes from sheepnomore.net, and it's entitled from 2013-11-21, Airline Mechanic Blows the Whistle on Chemtrail Operation. So you can look it up, or you can go to our Facebook page for Black Swamp Radio, and you can read it there. You just have to scroll down and find it. I thought this story was very interesting. Chemtrails have been known to have barium and aluminum and several other chemicals inside of them. And every time that you go to get them tested, for some reason, there's always an issue or a problem. Or how can you actually prove that came from the airplane when it's already on the ground? Some people think that the chemtrails are like out there putting out mass flu vaccinations and all this other kind of happy stuff that I don't know if it's the case. I'm not even going to try to presume or give an opinion on that. But I don't put past the government these days to do anything. Now this leads me right into my next thing. Our government. Did you know in the 1940s our government officials did not get paid for their jobs? All the way up to the 1940s, our government officials, while they were in office, did it on a voluntary basis. They had everything that they needed provided for them so that they could live. But the whole premises of them not being paid so that they could not be influenced, they were not allowed to make any money while they were in office, so that they could not be influenced by big major corporations and so on and so forth. And now being a politician is big money. Why is everyone corrupt? Why can't you find an honest person? And you only find people in our government that have their own agendas? Well, because they're just out there anymore to make money, just like an attorney. Unless you have the money, an attorney don't care about you. The attorney only cares about moving to the next case. They only care about perpetuating their life and getting to the next level. They don't care about you. If you have big money or the money to pay them, then you get off. I mean, look at O.J. Simpson. Took him every single penny he had to stay out of prison. And that's why he stayed out of prison. Because he paid all that money to stay out of prison. Now he has nothing. But he got away with murder. And that's the way that it works. That's why you can't. Well, that's why you go, when you go up against big business, they have all these lawyers and you don't have but one. And it's like, well, basically what it comes down to is that the single attorney that's going out big ones, it's like, well, if you want to go anywhere in your job, then you are going to go our way. It's all about money. And we go on to my next topic. Supreme Court will authorize FEMA internment camps. This story comes from activistpost.com. The United States Supreme Court once again says that it is lawful and they will allow the use of internment FEMA camps to be used in America as they were used in World War II. And during World War II, Japanese Americans were labeled enemies and many thousands were placed in what we refer to today as a FEMA camp. All you have to do is look at history and you will see how the Japanese were treated during World War II. Now, when the Supreme Court says it's legal now for the FEMA camps, which have been all enabled prior to the Supreme Court saying this, it's just a legality. It's coming, man. The FEMA camps, it's legal. They're open. I have two by me. Something is coming down. Something will happen. Either they're going to fake a terrorist attack, or they're going to knock out some of the power grid so that they have an excuse to bring in the military for martial law. And we are already under martial law, if you didn't realize it. You're not free to do anything anymore. You're not free to speak your peace anymore, because if you make too much noise, you disappear or you're killed. Now on to a different topic for a minute, because I want to ask you this question. Do you believe that our government and our police departments have any right whatsoever into operating drones that are as small and look just like mosquitoes and other insects? Snoops.com says this is real. I gave my opinion about Snoops.com earlier, but Snoops says it's real. And I swear the last few summers I have seen insects that just didn't look right, and I just try to kill them, try to smash them. You know, it's paranoia. They say it's paranoia when someone comes around you or some insect comes around you and you think that they're spying on you. Well, it's not paranoia anymore. But just why the hell would they want to do that? Why would they want to use a drone to maybe come into your house to see what's going on? Are you a bad person? Do you really do anything that's wrong? Okay, well, maybe you look at porn at night. You know, big deal. As long as it's not kiddie porn, I don't have a problem with you. Or, you know, maybe once in a while you download something that you shouldn't. Well, do you want the mosquito that's sitting on the table next to you watching this with a camera recording everything that you do? Has the police state come to a point where you are nothing more than a way for the government to expand and make money? Think about it. Just think about it. Oh, and while I'm thinking about it, Philip Morris introduces Marlboro marijuana cigarettes. That story is not true. That's been busted. That's crap. But yeah, it's bad enough that they have helicopters flying all over and the cops are looking at to do this, that, and the other thing. I'm in favor of marijuana used for medicinal purposes and so on. I don't have a single issue with it whatsoever. The whole reason that they made pot illegal was because prohibition ended and the FBI didn't have anything to do. So they made pot illegal. Basically, that's what the truth of it is. I don't smoke. And what can I say about that? I don't smoke anymore. I did when I was young, but who didn't? At one time in my life, I used to party. But still, you know, have you seen the little drones? The little ones with the cameras on them? They've got the four propellers. They're basically silent and they just hover there and they go every which way. Have you seen those drones? I wonder what would happen if you shot one. Not necessarily with a gun. I mean, if you saw a drone flying by the bedroom window while your wife was taking a shower or something, seems to me that you would have every right to shoot that thing out of the sky. That's an invasion of privacy. Think about it. Do you want that? Oh, they decide, oh, well, it's eminent domain. We're just looking through the window because it's open. And she just happened to be standing there naked. Well, I'm sorry, but if I take my binoculars and I look through somebody else's window, that's a crime. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. That's a crime. So why is it not a crime for the government to do the same thing? Because they're the government and they can? It's time for people to pull up their bootstraps and say enough is enough. You know, this show is supposed to be more paranormal. This show is supposed to be about ghosts or Bigfoot or UFOs, because I like those topics and because I hate politics. But sometimes things just build up and build up, and I have no choice but to come out here on the radio and share what I know. And either you listen to it or you don't. Either you do the research or you don't. Don't just take my word for it. Please don't just take my word for it. Please gather up your own snow before it all melts away and have it tested. That way you know for yourself what is true and what is not. And after you know it's true, then somebody else can't tell you you're being paranoid. Someone else can't tell you it's full of crap. Because you know beyond a shadow of a doubt, well, guess what? This is about, it's not about even keeping our freedoms anymore as much as it's about keeping yourself together, keeping your family safe. Keeping it so that the law can't just bust in like they did in Nazi Germany 60 years ago and just take you and your family, separate them, and put them wherever. Because they can. This is turning into Nazi Germany. And I know a lot of you younger people don't understand what Nazi Germany was like. Living inside Nazi Germany was not any more fun than living in Poland or anywhere else around Germany. It wasn't any more fun. It was just as terrifying. It's just like Russia. All someone had to do is decide they didn't like you and say. It didn't have to be true. All they had to do was say, hey, that guy over there, he's a pedophile. Or that woman over there who's a teacher, likes to sleep with her boy class kids. It's not true, but that's all they had to say for someone to bust into their house and take them away. And they didn't even have to say that much. All they had to do was say, you know, he was talking crap about Hitler, and that was enough for them to bust in. It was like that 60 years ago, and it's going to be like that again. Everything is falling into place, man. I don't want to see that happen. And the only thing I can do is come out here on the radio and let y'all know what's up. To the best of my ability, I don't give out stories that are not true. You say, well, what are we supposed to do about it? Well, this is what you do about it. You pay attention. When it comes into your neighborhood, you stop it. You know, one of the first things they did a while back was put in police cameras on the streets. That was highly illegal when they did that. And it's still illegal. Some courts claim that it's okay. But you do that. You take a camera. You put it in your, if you're on a major street. You take a camera. You put it in your front yard. And you start filming cars. And see how fast the cops come around to tell you, you can't do that, that's illegal. Well, if it's illegal for you to do it, And you, my friend, are the one that's in charge, not the cops. You pay their salaries. You are the boss. People have forgot that here. If it's illegal for you to do that, then why is it legal for them? It's kind of like the gun thing. In the 1940s, they used to teach children in school with live ammunition and live guns how to take care of those weapons, how to fire those weapons and be safe. After they stopped doing that, children finding guns and there be child deaths from guns rose. After people stopped learning how to be safe and how to fire a rifle and how to actually use a rifle or a handgun, after that stopped in the schools, that's when things start to get bad. It's not the gun. It's the person. And it's not necessarily that the person is bad. It's the naivety of the person. Oh, well, I didn't think my kid would find the gun. That's just a point. You didn't think. Like I said before, what do we do about this? We stay alert. We stay awake. We care about the stories that we read. We pass them on. We don't let things happen. We care. We watch our children. We control our children. We keep them from doing things that they shouldn't be doing. We do what's right is what we do. And we don't stand for the cops just coming in here and doing whatever they want to do, or the government. That's my podcast. I will give more updates at a later date. Hopefully, I think there's still hope for a new computer to be on its way, but I can't guarantee that. So, thanks to all the listeners out there. Be well, be safe. Until next time, I will see you. Bye.